guys, welcome to my channel. So if you have been following me regularly on Instagram, you would know how much I love home decor. As a part of my living room makeover, I have recently taken up a TV cabinet that we had and painted it. I personally believe that painting can kind of make the old furniture look new. Plus, if you are using oil paints, then it kind of makes your furniture stain proof. So I'm going to take you through the entire process of this lovely makeover and share with you all the products I used, all my tips and tricks, and whatever you need to know about giving your furniture a beautiful makeover. So let's get started. The color scheme that I've decided for our living room is mostly white and gray. So to match with this color theme, I decided to paint our TV cabinet white. I have a strong inclination for the color white. So there would be a lot of furniture at our home you would see is of white color. Either it is hand painted white or it is brought white. I even painted my bed in white color, and I will soon share the video of how I painted it with all of you. The colors that I'm using today are oil based, and you can use these colors practically on all sort of wood furniture, on wood, on plywood, and on the sheet that we use on the plywood, which is decorum. And this paint works absolutely beautifully in all those surfaces. I have never faced any problem of like paint coming out or peeling off, but for this, priming is very important. Last time when I was painting, since I use oil based colors, all of my brushes became very hard even though I cleaned them with turpentine oil. When I went to the paint shop, uncle advised me to buy the thinner and dip the brushes in that. So today I'm going to do this. I have just dipped my brushes with the just almost 1 inch of this thinner, and I can already see that they are becoming softer. So this is a very good tip for all those whose brushes bristles are getting harder. You can dip them in thinner and get them to work again. I'll wait for 10 minutes and then I'll get started with my project. This is how the area looks like now. So this is how the cabinet looks after cleaning up all the books and the material that was inside it. It was definitely very tiring, but I had to do it. Now I'm going to clean it with the liquid detergent. I'll just use Vim liquid, put it in some water, and then wipe the cabinet off to get a very clean surface to start priming. So guys, while cleaning it, we have to make sure that water is not too soapy. Otherwise, while painting, it might leave some bubbles. So I'm taking this container. I have only used 2 drops of Vim liquid in it, and I have filled it until here with water. Now I'm going to use this green scrub to clean the surface off, and then I'll wipe it off with another cloth and then dry it off with another cloth. So let's get started. I have cleaned it already with the Vim liquid soap wash and also wiped it again with a little damp cloth. Now I'll wait for 2 minutes for it to dry. I'll start sanding it a little, because the surface needs to be a little rough for the primer and the paint to stick together on this cabinet. Sanding should be done in a way that doesn't leave any scratch marks on the plywood. So I'm sanding it first with the grit 220. It's the perfect grit. If I take anything lower than this, then it leaves scratches, and if I take a grit paper higher than this, then it doesn't sand the surface much. So it will take a while before I finish sanding the entire cabinet. Once it is done, I'll clean it off with a microfiber cloth and then start priming. And I have wiped off all the dust from the cabinet. As you see over there, there were some gaps that I had to fill with wood putty. So I've used this wood putty. I have had it for quite a long time with me. I used it while painting the headboard of my bed, and today I used this for filling the gaps in this TV cabinet also. I've used these sheets that you can easily get from any painting shop, and just that make sure that once you're done with your job, clean them on the spot immediately, otherwise this putty would remain on the plates and the plates will become completely waste, and they can be literally used again and again provided that you clean them on the spot. So this is the brush I'm using, guys. I have already put on my gloves, and this is the primer I will be using. So I'll shake it well, vigorously shake it, and then use it. As yesterday I told you that I am going to prime it, so this is how it looks after the priming. Today I am going to apply the first coat of the paint. So this is how it looks now after two coats. I must say, the process was definitely tiring, but it was a lot of fun. So I hope that you also try some kind of makeover in your home, and do share it with us in the comment section below. I wish you all good health and well-being. Thank you, and see you in the next video. Thank you.